This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this is going to be the third and last video about the addition of signed or positive and negative numbers. And in this video, I just want to look at some patterns that we get when we add numbers. Sometimes patterns help us understand how a process works. So what I've got here is a bunch of addition facts. I'm taking the number positive 3 and adding other numbers to it. I'm adding a positive 2 and a positive 1, a 0, a negative 1, and so on. So in other words, I'm decreasing the number I add onto positive 3 by 1 each time. So let's look at what happens and look at the signs. When I add a positive 3 and a positive 2, I get a positive 5. So adding two positive numbers together, I'm going to end up with a positive number. The same thing happens with positive 3 and positive 1. I end up with a positive 4. Then I go down to positive 3 plus 0. Well, adding 0 to a number doesn't change it at all, so I'm still going to have a positive. I'll still have positive 3. Now I'm moving into the area where I'm adding negative numbers to positive 3. Positive 3 plus negative 1 is positive 2. Now, the logic behind this is that the 3, the absolute value of 3, is greater than the absolute value of 1. So I'm going to use the sign that the 3 had, which was positive. And then I just want to find the difference between those two absolute values. I want to find the difference between 3 and 1, and that's 2. The same thing happens when I add positive 3 and negative 2. I end up with a positive number because 3 is bigger than 2, and I take the difference of those two numbers, of their absolute values, and the difference between 3 and 2 is 1. Now I come down to positive 3 plus negative 3, and I get a 0. Well, positive 3 and negative 3 are what we call additive inverses. In other words, a number and its opposite, like positive 3 and negative 3, add together to make 0. We call those additive inverses. So anytime we have the same number but just two different signs, the result is going to be a 0. Going further, we have a positive 3 and a plus negative 4. I've got two different signs. I'm going to find the sign, the number with the larger absolute value, that's the 4, and I'm going to use the sign that it had, which was negative, so my answer is going to be negative, and then I take the difference of the absolute values. So in all these cases, when you were dealing with numbers with two different signs, you took the sign of the number that had the larger positive value, and then you found the difference of the absolute value of those two numbers. So I get a negative 1 for this one, and for the next, positive 3 plus negative 5, I get a negative again, I get negative 2. Okay? Let's look at one more page of addition. In this case, I want to start out with a negative number. I'm starting out with negative 2. And then I'm going to add positive 4, positive 3, positive 2, positive 1. I'll keep decreasing by 1 in the amount that I add to that negative 2. So I've got negative 2 plus positive 4. The signs are different. I want to take the sign of the number with the larger absolute value, which is 4. So I'm going to have a positive sign for my answer. And then I want to take the difference between those two absolute values. So the difference between 2 and 4 is 2. Same thing that happens when I have negative 2 and positive 3. I have a positive sign because 3 is greater than 2. The difference between 3 and 2 is 1, so I've got positive 1. Now I come to negative 2 plus positive 2. So these are additive inverses. They're opposites of each other. When I add the opposites, I get a 0. And now my results are going to turn negative. I've got negative 2 plus positive 1. Now the larger of the two absolute values is the 2, which means I'm going to use its sign, which is negative, and I'll find the difference between 2 and 1, which is 1, the difference of the absolute values. Same thing happens well, not exactly the same. When I have negative 2 plus 0, well, adding 0 to something doesn't change its value at all. So negative 2 plus 0 is just negative 2. And now I'm in an area where I'm adding two negative numbers. Negative 2 plus negative 1 is negative 3. When the signs are the same, then what I'm doing is I'm adding the absolute value of the two numbers and using the sign that they both had. The same thing happens when I have negative 2 plus negative 2. I add their absolute values, which is 4. They were both negative, so I use a negative sign. So you might want to think about these patterns and just use that maybe as a way to remember what's going on when you're adding positive and negative numbers. That's about it for this. Take care. I'll see you next time.